Hello, Dr. Allen here for the last time. We are on our last frontal section, which is brain slice block number 7. This slice is, although it's labeled as a frontal slice, which remember, frontal separates anterior versus posterior, but I want to show you with the plastic model. The other slices were more up and down like this, clearly separating anterior and posterior with a nice vertical line. However, on block number 7, it's more of a diagonal or oblique kind of angle. So a little bit different than the others. So that's part of the reason why we saved this one for last. That makes it a little tricky. Okay, so where in the world are we? We can still see our two lateral ventricles here in the cerebrum. We can still see cortex with gray matter and white matter, not pointing that out again because you already know that. We can still see corpus callosum. Insula is not, there's not a good view of it anyway, not one that I would ask you guys about. But I am seeing another little open space right here, and this should look familiar. We saw a similar effect on a previous brain slice. This little hole right here, well, that's got to be the cerebral aqueduct. Remember, the cerebral aqueduct connects the third and the fourth ventricles, and you may be thinking, well, how in the world does she know that? Well, that's partially because I've already seen the other side of this slice. So let's take a look at that. So when I flip this one around, in this view, I'm seeing almost feathery looking gyri. They're a bit darker as well than most of what we've seen. So that is all cerebellum. And remember, the cerebellum is the most posterior region of the brain, or that's at least one of the ways you can tell where posterior is. And looking here at the cerebellum, I can see a nice big open space right next to it. That's got to be the fourth ventricle, which helps me to confirm that when I flip this back around to the other side, the little one here must be connecting to it. So that has got to be the cerebral aqueduct, which means that this is the midbrain once again. And I can see some little bumps happening here. So that's a portion of the corpora quadridemina, those little bumps. And then if I flip this around, not only can I see cerebellum with its gyri, its ridges, and the fourth ventricle, but remember what sat on the other side of the fourth ventricle, the pons. Remind yourself by looking at the plastic model where we can see cerebellum, fourth ventricle, and pons on the other side. And that is it. You made it. I'd like to thank our lab manager, Chris Standing, for recording those videos. He was a huge help. Thank you guys so much, and good luck studying these brain blocks.